students, welcome to the math class. Student, we have started the chapter circles and we have completed its first four objectives, that is equation of circle in standard form, second center form and the diameter form of the circle, third parametric form and the general form of circle, and fourth, to find center and radius of the circle for the given general form. Today, we are going to start with its fifth objective, that is to find the equation of circle passing through three non-collinear points. Then we will complete the sixth objective also, that is to find the equation of circle whose center lies on a line and the circle passing through two points. Now let's start with the fifth objective. Equation of circle passing through three non-collinear points. Here non-collinear means the points, those are not lying in one line. Those points are called the non-collinear points. For example, these are the three points A, B and C. These are not lying in one line, so they are called non-collinear points. Now, instead of giving a center or radius, three non-collinear points are given and we have to find its equation. Now, let's take an example. So, find the equation of circle passing through the points 1, minus 2, second point is 5, 4 and third point is 10, 5. Now, three points are given. These three points are A, B and C. Now, we will start the question from the equation of the circle. We will start with the general form. So, equation of circle be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Now for finding the equation, we require three values, that is g, f and c. Now it passes through three points, that is a, b and c. So we'll put this point in the equation one by one. Now first point is 1, minus 2. Put in the equation, we get 1 plus 4 plus 2g minus 4f plus c is equal to 0. Here when you shift this constant term to the other side, we get the equation, that is 2g minus 4f plus c is equal to minus 5. Mark it equation number 2. Now, pass the equation through the point B, that is 5, 4. We get 25 plus 16 plus 10g plus 8f plus c is equal to 0. Again, shifting 25 plus 16, that is 41 on the other side, we get 10g plus 8f plus c is equal to minus 41. Mark it equation number 3. Now, similarly from the third point, it is 10, 5. We get 100 plus 25 plus 20g plus 10f plus c is equal to 0. Again, shifting 100 plus 25, that is 125 on the right hand side, we get the equation 20g plus 10f plus c is equal to minus 125. Now, we are having three equations in three variables, that is g, f and c. So, firstly, we will solve these three equations to reduce it into the two variables by using elimination method. So first we are going to take third and second. Now third minus second gives 10g plus 8f plus c is equal to minus 41 and second equation is 2g minus 4f plus c is equal to minus 5. Now when you do the elimination using subtraction, their sign will change. So here it will become negative, it is plus, again minus and plus. Now c will cancel with c. and we are left with 10 minus 2, that is 8g. Here 8 plus 4 is 12f, and minus 41 plus 5 is equal to minus 36. Now you can see 4 is a common factor. So divide the whole equation with 4. We get 2g plus 3f is equal to minus 9. Mark it equation number 5. Now we are left with 2 variables only. Similarly, solve 4th and 2nd. You can solve 4th and 3rd also. Now, 4th equation is 20g plus 10f plus c is equal to minus 125. And 2nd is 2g minus 4f plus c is equal to minus 5. Again, elimination by subtraction, sign will change. So, it becomes minus, here plus, minus and plus. So, again, c and c will cancel out. So, we are left with 20 minus 2 is 18g plus 10 plus 4 is 14f, and here 120 plus 5 is minus 120. Now, in this equation, 2 is a common factor, so divide by 2, we get 9g plus 7f is equal to minus 60. Now, we will solve equation number 5 and 6 for finding the value of f and g. Now, these are the two equations. Now, for making the coefficient of g equal, first multiply with 9, and second is multiply with the 2. So, on multiplying 9 and 2, we get 18g plus 27f is equal to minus 81, and second is 18g plus 14f is equal to minus 120. Now here, when you do the elimination by subtraction, sign will change. So 18g cancel with 18g, we are left with 27 minus 14, that is 13f, and on this side minus 81 plus 120. Now here 13f cancel with 39, so it is 3. From here we will get the value of f, that is f is equal to 3. Now put this value of f is equal to 3 in equation number 5 also. So, 2g plus 3 into 3 is equal to minus 9. This is the value of f. So, we get 2g, here 9 shifted to other side. So, minus 9 and minus 9 will become minus 18. So, after cutting, we are left with 2 9s are 18. So, it is g is equal to minus 9. Now we are having the value of f and value of g. Put this value of f and g in equation number 2. We get 2 into minus 9, that is the value of g, minus 4, this is the value of f, 4 into 3 plus c is equal to minus 5. So here we get minus 18 minus 12, that is minus 30. When you shift minus 30 on other side, we get minus 5 plus 30. So, value of c is 25. Now, put the value of f, g and c in the equation. We get the equation of circle, that is x square plus y square minus 18x plus 6y plus 25 is equal to 0. In this way, we can find the equation of circle passing through three non-collinear points. Now, let's discuss the next type. Now, when equation of circle passing through two points, here circle is passing through two points only, and they have given one another condition that the center lies on the given line. In the figure, if you want to represent, it will be like this. This is a circle, it's passing through these two points, and the center lies on this line. It means they have given the equation of diameter. Now, let's try one question based on this type. Find the equation of circle passing through the points A2, 3 and B is minus 1, 1, and whose center lies on the line x minus 3y minus 11 equal to 0. Now here these two are the passing points. Again we will start from the general equation. Let the equation of circle be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Again, pass it through the first point and the second point. We get through first point, that is 2, 3, 4 + 9 + 4g + 6f + c = 0. On simplifying, 4g + 6f + c = -30. Similarly, from the second point, that is -1, 1, we get 1 + 1 - 2g + 2f + c = 0. Now from here again 2 shifted on the side, we get -2g + 2f + c = -2. Now firstly we will solve these two equations to eliminate c. So 2 - 3 is, when you subtract, their sign will change. It will become plus, minus, minus and plus. Again here c cancel with c. So we are left with 4 + 2 = 6g, 6 - 2 = +4f, and here 3 - 13 + 2 = -11. So this is the equation number 4. Now next condition they have given, center lies on the line x - 3y - 11 = 0. Now center is -g, -f. So put these points in this equation, we get -g + 3f - 11 = 0. Here 11 shifted on other side, we get -g + 3f = 11. Now we will solve equation number 4 and 5 for finding the value of g and f. Now here coefficient of g is 6, and in this equation coefficient of g is -1. So here fifth equation is multiplied with 6 and then added to equation number 4. So first write down the equation number 4, that is 6g + 4f = -11. And second, when you multiply fifth equation with 6, we get -6g + 18f = 66. Now here when you do elimination by addition, 6g cancel with -6g. Here 18 + 4 = 22f, and 66 - 11 = 55. So on shifting 22, we get 55/22, and after cutting with 11, we get 5/2. So this is the value of f. Now put the value of f in any one of these equations to get the value of g. Put f is equal to 3/2 in equation number 4, we get 6g + 4f. This is the value of f. 5/2 = -11. Now here do the cutting, 2 2s are 4, so we are left with 6g. Here it is +10, shifted on other side, we get -11 - 10, so it becomes -21. So when you shift 6, we get -21/6. Now here cutting is possible, do the cutting with the table of 3, so it is 7 and 2. So value of g is -7/2. Now put the value of f and g in equation number 3 to find the value of c. So we get -2 × -7/2, this is the value of g. Then +2 × 5/2, this is the value of f, plus c plus 2 is equal to 0. So here 2 cancel with 2. Again here 2 cancel with 2. So we are left with 7 + 5 + c + 2 = 0. Now here 7 + 5 + 2 = 14. So shift to other side, we get the value of c, that is equal to -14. Now put this value of f, g and c in the equation 1. We get x² + y² + 2 × -7/2, x + 2 × 5/2, -14 = 0. Here 2 cancel with 2. Again here 2 cancel with 2. So we are left with x² + y² - 7x + 5y - 14 = 0. This is the equation of circle passing through 2 points and the center lies on the given line. Students, I hope you got these two types related to the circle. Now, before starting the work given in your SNAP homework and start solving the sum of the exercise, go through the links guided in the Snap homework. Rest, we will continue in our next class. Thank you.